The sister said about the proper way of praying witr. And I hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would bless us to understand that when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam presented an act of worship in various ways, this is a concession that Allah gave us in order to make things easy for us. He said, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرَ وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرَ. Allah intends to give you ease, and He does not want to make things difficult for you. But sometimes, out of lack of knowledge or out of prejudice, we tend to make things extremely difficult upon ourselves. So Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did pray the three rak'ahs of the witr all together, but without tashahud after the second rak'ah, and only with tashahud and tasdeem after the third rak'ah. In this case, Sister Afra, the imam or the ma'moom, if you're praying singular, will get to recite al-fatiha in each rak'ah and a surah afterward. The sunnah, as it's been reported in this case, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recited in the first rak'ah after al-fatiha, surah al-a'la, sabbih isma rabbika al-a'la. And in the second, surah al-kafirun, qul ya ayyuhal kafirun. And in the third, surah al-ikhlas. What if somebody recited any other surahs? It is permissible. But we're talking about the tradition. Also, if the order is different, or recited different surahs, but this is how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recited, or the companions heard him reciting most of the time. Some scholars or some imams would recite al-ikhlas in the last rak'ah along with the remaining two surahs, al-mu'awwidhatayn. That too is permissible. And if somebody decided to pray the witr by praying two, then tashahud and complete taslim, then one by itself, likewise, that too is permissible. The only form which is prohibited, as the Prophet ﷺ forbade us from making the witr similar to the Maghrib, is if you pray all three all together and sit in between. And I know that some people have this tradition, but say it is disliked to pray the witr similar to the Maghrib. Also, the Prophet ﷺ prayed the witr five rak'ahs or seven or nine. You can do that, and you can sit for the tashahud in the rak'ah before the last. Then tashahud and taslim in the last rak'ah. And do not forget about the qunut. It's also sunnah. And it is recommended to be recited. Al-qunut is to make dua in the salah. Is to be recited after rising up from ruku'ah. Wallahu ta'ala, a'la wa a'lam.